They say imitation is the greatest form of flattery. Any great filmmaker will tell you they are influenced by their predecessors, but some films take that influence too far. Mockbusters are knockoffs hoping to catch an easy audience with a variation. From a low-budget Chucky doll to a blatant Marvel comic ripoff, here are the 10 most ridiculous copies of famous movies.
Before we begin, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification bell for more amazing videos every day. With that being said, let's begin.
Number 10. Zapatala. Good horror movies are instant classics. Super campy movies make you jump, even if you don't believe in things like demonic possession. Do you remember the 80s classic Child's Play? Child's Play 2? Bride of Chucky? It's a classic doll meets demon, demon doll meets boy tale. Tatya Vinciu, the titular character from Zapatala, bears a striking resemblance to Chucky. Well, striking is a stretch, but you can tell they tried. Both stories center around a criminal possessing a doll to cheat death. The doll in the Indian counterpart is technically a ventriloquist dummy, not a child's toy. And Chucky was cute before possessed. The differences mostly end there. Zapatala is an unapologetic ripoff of Child's Play. And while the production is cornier, something about the way Tatya Vinciu moves is unsettling. After 20 years on the shelf, they made Zapatala 2, the first 3D movie shot in Marathi. And it looks even creepier. You only have to look at Tatya Vinciu and wonder, what possessed somebody to greenlight these? Number 9. The Amazing Bulk. Don't get mad, get purple, is a nonsense tagline from the uninspired knockoff. The Amazing Bulk was filmed for $14,000 USD, and they didn't spend much of that on scriptwriters. Great movies make an impression that lasts a lifetime, but not everybody can come up with an idea that will be a success on the silver screen. The Incredible Hulk is a derivative Jekyll and Hyde character to begin with, but the house that Stan Lee built approaches that trope with some artistry. The Amazing Bulk keeps everything corny about the Hulk, with none of the human interest. It's such a blatant imitation, I found myself thinking that the only reason they didn't just go all in on the copying and make him green is because of the excessive use of green screen backgrounds. The crappy production is almost endearing, but you find yourself rooting against the cast for being so tacky. For such a simple concept, an ordinary man losing control, this movie is surprisingly hard to follow. Both have a super strong, pissed off guy. One's called Hank Howard, one's Bruce Banner. Both Hulk and Bulk have a general as a main character. The villain, Dr. Werner von Cantlove, is aided by his assistant, Lolita Cantlove, both named in homage to Dr. Strangelove. In one of the most pivotal scenes, Dr. Cantlove's rocket is hijacked by a space monkey. That part is definitely original, although I wouldn't say it's necessarily good. This one has a surprise ending that may be entertaining enough to sit through 90 minutes of stock footage and CGI Bulk rage. Number 8. Frozen Land. Right during the peak of the whirlwind surrounding the upcoming Disney release Frozen, Phase 4 Films released the animated film Frozen Land. It was originally called The Legend of Cirilla, until the film distributors rebranded the movie. The gutsiest thing about this cheap imitation is how closely they copied the title. Frozen is huge up top, Land is just a little afterthought down there. It's got the same swirly O. Disney doesn't play games when it comes to protecting their interests. It should come as no surprise Disney sued Phase 4 Films, claiming they were intentionally misleading consumers. The two studios settled out of court. Phase 4 Films was allowed to continue selling copies of the movie, but only under its original title, The Legend of Cirilla. They also paid $100,000 restitution and had to make a genuine effort to pull existing copies of Frozen Land from the shelves. Number 7. Transmorphers, Fall of Man. Transmorphers? You can't just make up words, man. That's taking it too far. This is a product of The Asylum, an American studio notorious for churning out mockbusters. Transformers: Revenge of the Fallen is an epic story about aliens warring for peace. Transmorphers: Fall of Man is about a bunch of human rebels being pursued by an evil Nissan Pathfinder. Big difference. Our favorite attempts to copy popular movies are the less successful attempts. Most movies about aliens and humanity have post-apocalyptic themes. The sentient, transmorphing robots, however, give it away as a shameless copy. Streaming platforms like Netflix have no loyalty to anybody but their customers, who do occasionally complain about being fooled by these clever copycats. An honorable mention goes to The Asylum title Age of the Hobbits, a movie that was never released. Warner Brothers sued The Asylum, and a judge told them they shall not pass Hobbits off as legitimately licensed characters. Especially not right before the release of The Hobbit, An Unexpected Journey. Number 6. Metal Man. Part man, part machine, all copied. From the same people who brought us The Amazing Bulk comes Metal Man. Are we looking at the original Iron Man or the copyright now? I can barely tell. Metal Man is not coy about imitating Iron Man, not even a little bit. It's got a lot going for it. Altruistic scientist? Check. Greedy industrialist backstabber? Check. Red? Check. Gold? Check. Where does Metal Man go wrong? Maybe it's the terrible acting, or the lack of the witty humor and lovable performance that brought Robert Downey Jr.'s character back to life. This one was originally titled Iron Hero. Maybe they changed it at the last moment as not to draw the ire of Marvel Studios. DC Studios is reviving the 60s series Metal Man anyway, so Metal Man might get another round of publicity. Boasting a whopping 1.6 rating on IMDb, Metal Man has got to be a real tanker. Number 5. Atlantic Rim. The producers of Pacific Rim should have seen this knockoff coming from the notorious folks at the Asylum. That was probably a quick meeting the day this imitation sci-fi action movie was pitched. Imagine the meeting. Okay, what can we do for Pacific Rim? Atlantic Rim. It practically writes itself. In one movie, monsters come from the deep sea, and humans build giant robots to fight them. In the other movie, people use giant robots to fight monsters coming from the sea, possibly originating in another dimension. Just watch the one directed by Academy Award winner Guillermo del Toro, featuring the guys from Sons of Anarchy, unless your goal is to laugh at the cheesy Power Ranger-like robot effects. Number 4. Alien Origin. In June 2012, director Ridley Scott released Prometheus, a prequel to the 1979 sci-fi masterpiece Alien. Right after Prometheus premiered, the Asylum released Alien Origin. What is most surprising about this imitation is that this one doesn't take place in a nearly identical setting as the original. Alien Origin takes place on Earth and has more of a Blair Witch Project feel than it does imitate the tense mood in the spaceship where Alien takes place. Found footage from a military mission reveals that the team made an unusual discovery. Aliens. The discovery is supposed to explain the origins of humanity, but the film is not called Human Origin. The only thing this one gets right is the tradition of alien movies having a female scientist as the hero. If you ever imagined making an original film for art's sake, it's shocking that these filmmakers would dare to copy famous titles and do it so blatantly. Number 3. Snakes on a Train. 100 people versus 1,000 snakes. It would be an entertaining concept if it were unique. Snakes on a Train feels like the kind of movie that was made by drunk frat boys. Lots of man versus wild horror and action movies exist. A movie called Snakes on a Plane already existed. As you know, riding on the coattails of other successful movies is the Asylum's main strategy. Snakes on a Train is one of the Asylum's first movies. Rumor goes that one of the movie's most iconic scenes was written based on a misunderstanding. The producers were shopping around a poster concept with a giant snake swallowing a train. Very conceptual. The Japanese investor took the idea literally and showed interest in that scene, which was created retroactively to keep his interest. Number 2. Aliens vs. Avatars. Did you like the Invisible Alien movie? How about the Blue Alien movie? Well then, let's mix them together. While most knockoff movies only copy one popular movie, Aliens vs. Avatars rips off two, Alien vs. Predator and Avatar. Two well-received movies that should not be mixed together, not on a low budget at least. The tagline for Aliens vs. Avatars is, "Don't get caught in the middle." Good advice. Predictably, this movie is about some regular folks caught up in the drama between two alien species. In this movie, the aliens are a destructive race called the Scythe. This movie treats avatars like their own kind of species, which isn't what an avatar even is. If you saw Avatar, you know that avatars are virtual world skins, making this ripoff even more confusing. Disney popularizes so many folktales in the public domain, it's curious that someone would rip off an original story. But these filmmakers aren't concerned with logic. Number 1. Kiara the Brave. Not fazed by the 2005 legal problems faced after Frozen Land, Phase 4 Films released, retitled, and repackaged the Indian animated film titled Super K as Kiara the Brave, after Pixar's Brave. Kiara the Brave takes things to another level with the addition of sorcery and magic. Clever as they tried to be, it's easy even for young audiences to tell the two apart. Kiara the Brave does have a red-headed child hero with a lovable king father in a medieval setting. However, the animation looks like an early 2000s video game at best. Isn't stealing characters, plot elements, and marketing illegal? Well, it can be hard to prove in court, and imitators can manage to get their movie out before the court stops the movie distribution, which can be impossible when international borders are involved. The Disney version won an Oscar. The copy earned a 1.2 out of 10 rating on IMDb. With all the aspiring screenwriters around the world, it's a wonder film producers recycle ideas. But as long as fans keep choosing these titles, intentionally or unintentionally, imitators will keep on imitating. Have you seen other crazy examples of filmmakers helping themselves to other movies' ideas? Do you think they're sleazy or just uncreative? Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen now. See you next time!